which regions hold the most promise for wind investment and development?
I think clearly there's long-term and short-term in this. Long-term, United States, China, Asia, Africa. In the near term, it's more Northern Europe as opposed to Southern Europe, and clearly the offshore market in Western Europe.
Okay. How can the wind industry increase capital flow?
Actually, by delivering and becoming more competitive. For wind energy and all renewables to stand up, particularly in this time of economic austerity and people are worried about customers, we need to take the cost out of it. It needs to continue to become more competitive with conventional power. Now, fortunately, since decisions around Germany and nuclear, people are getting to appreciate the real cost of conventional power. You know, the two are going to meet in the middle, but we still need to work to make the industry more reliable, cheaper, and more competitive. And when people can see that it can survive with less subsidies or without subsidies, then we're going to start seeing the capital really flow, because the number one nervousness that capital has is the reliance on subsidies.
Okay. What do you think are the key challenges in attracting offshore wind?
I've thought about this a bit. I think there are three things. Some of them are obvious, and one of them is a little bit less obvious. The first one is cost. And it's the point before that it is expensive and people are worried about the cost. The second one is reliability of the equipment. The first offshore wind projects didn't do that well. The technology wasn't there. The early indications from the newest rounds of equipment are very good, but we still need some more operating history over that. Third one is around construction and those risks. We have seen risks, you know, and foundations and everything on some of the, you know, later offshore wind projects be very expensive to fix. Those, I think, will get fixed in time. And I guess I lied. There's probably a fourth one. And that's what I'm going to call, for Europe at least, concentration risk. If you can get over the pricing, the technical, and the construction risks, at the end of the day, in Europe, all of the offshore wind is being built effectively in the same wind resource. And there's also what I'm going to call a concentration risk around equipment. Right now, we've got two, maybe three manufacturers. And at some point, I think banks and equity investors have become concerned, if I have a bad wind year in the English North Atlantic, well, I'm probably going to have a bad year in the German wind year in the German North Atlantic. So you've got a wind concentration. If there's a problem with Siemens turbines, or Vestas, or Areva, whoever they are, the three major, there's probably going to be a problem in a whole bunch of them. And so I think at some point people will have a worry that, am I too concentrated? Do I have too much exposure to North Sea wind in terms of the wind resource? And do I have too much concentration risk on manufacturers for still what is pretty new technology?
Okay.